नमस्कार दोस्तों, कैसे हैं आप सब? आशा करता हूँ सब अच्छे होंगे। एक्चुअली जब भी हम कुछ पढ़ते हैं तो बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस हमारे दिमाग में वहाँ पे आने लगता है कि यस, ये कैसे हुआ, वो कैसे हुआ, राइट? तो जब भी मैंने आपको बताया था ये इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशंस के बारे में, तो हो सकता है क्योंकि ये ऑनलाइन क्लास है तो आप लोग एट अ टाइम क्वेश्चन अराइज नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन मैंने आपको ऑप्शन दिया था कि जब भी अगर आपको ऐसा फील हो कि नहीं मुझे डाउट है, मुझे सर से क्वेश्चन पूछना है, तो मैंने आपको कहा है कि आप कमेंट बॉक्स में लिख सकते हो, राइट? लेकिन पता नहीं बच्चे लिख नहीं रहे कमेंट्स में कि सर मुझे डाउट है या नहीं है। इफ़ यू रियली हैव अ डाउट देन प्लीज ड्रॉप योर डाउट इन टू द कमेंट बॉक्स सेक्शन सो आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड रियली दैट यू आर हैविंग अ डाउट। सी फर्स्ट थिंग, in the previous video I had explained you about the wave theory. After the wave theory, electromagnetic radiations, how the temperature or intensity is directly proportional to the wavelength or energy. After then Planck's quantum theory, photoelectric effect, and in the previous video I had explained you that after this video I will give you numerical. In the previous video I had said this. So definitely, in this video, I am going to give you the numericals of this chapter. Whatever you have understand the theory concept, either if I talk about the wave theory, if I talk about the quantum theory, means Planck's quantum, photoelectric effect, each and every topic related numericals today we are going to solve. So let's start with, first of all, wave theory, that is electromagnetic spectrum. As already I have said you that C is equal to nu into lambda. See, each and every theoretical portion I have already explained you. C is equal to nu into lambda, as in the previous video I had informed you also. So whenever you are getting any concept, write the formula. If you understand the things, then it's okay. If you don't understand the things, what happens, you know, nowadays the students are thinking that whenever they are getting a theoretical concept, at the same time they want practical concept also, right? You just think that if you are studying about the rice, if a farmer, agricultural university is teaching about the rice, how the paddy plants will grow, in which season they will grow, this type of things. At the same time, you can't cook and you can't eat that, right? But you get a concept about the, how the paddy plants grow. Similarly, whenever you are getting a concept about any of the theory, either wave theory, Planck's quantum theory, any chapter, not only about this chapter, if you are getting a concept about that chapter, please write that. And whenever the question comes to solve, any numericals come, if you are not having a numerical, then you can download from the Google. There are thousands of numericals. If you are downloading this type of numerical, then you solve the type of questions. And if you are getting a doubt, then please drop your doubt into the comment box section. So I can understand that this concept, this student have not understood. Got it? So let's start. As already I have written, C is equal to lambda into nu. Now question is what? Here, C is speed of light. What is speed of light? All of you know very well. 3 lakh kilometer per second. 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second is equal to lambda into nu or nu into lambda. If you want to find the nu, then nu will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second upon lambda. Or if you find lambda, then 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second upon nu. Right? So according to this, we have got the three formulas. Right? Now question I am giving you, just suppose you have to calculate the wavelength frequency both. If I give you a light wave whose time period is 3 into 10 to the power minus 10 seconds, and question is that you have to find lambda frequency both and time period is equal to 3 into 10 to the power minus 10 second. 3 into 10 to the power minus 10 second. See, if you see this type of question, that time you will be very much confused. You will tell, sir, you have taught here C is equal to lambda into nu. See, at the C same time, whenever I have described about the frequency, I have told you what is frequency? 1 upon time period, right? So here see, as the time period is given, so frequency nu is equal to 1 upon t, right? So 1 upon 3 into 10 to the power minus 10 second. So if this go up, just suppose 10 into 10 to the power 9 by 3 second inverse, 10 by 3 is 9, 3.3 into 10 to the power 9 second inverse, right? This is the frequency value, right? If you want to write 3.33, that also you can write 3.3, that is also okay. Okay? So new value you have got it. Now you have seen here, as you get a new value, then definitely you can calculate the lambda value. What is lambda? Lambda is equal to C by nu. C value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And here 3.33 into 10 to the power 9 meter per second, 9 second inverse. Got it? Here with the second inverse, second second cancel. Now you can see here. As here 8 and here 9 zeros are there. Are you understanding? Here 8 and here 9 zeros are there. So what you will do? Are you able to understand? Here you can see, as the frequency you have got it. Frequency is 3.33. or 3.3 into 10 to the power 9 per second. So now wavelength will be C by nu. So what will be the value of wavelength? 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second and 3.3 into 10 to the power 9 second inverse. So now after division, what will be the answer, you know? 9 upon 100. Now you will ask how 9 upon 100. Right? You can ask, sir, how 9 upon 100? It's very easy. That also I am seeing. How 9 upon 100? Can you tell me? Just suppose 30 into 10 to the power 7 upon 10 to the power 7, 7 cancel. If you will divide 30 by 3, you see, 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30. Since you have 3.33 is there, so after division, 9 point something will come, right? So 9 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter will be our wavelength. Got it? And at the same time, if you want to count wave number, what is wave number? The quantity specially used in the spectroscopy is called wave number. It is defined as the number of wavelengths per unit length. Number of wavelengths per unit length. So what is wavelength? You know very well. Wavelength of wave number is equal to 1 by 8. So 1 upon 9 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. So here 100 upon 9 meter inverse. So 9 1 is 9. 11.11 meter inverse. So here you have seen, as I have calculated, only with the time period, I can calculate frequency, I can calculate wavelength, I can calculate wave number. Have you got it? So if this type of question comes, can you calculate? I'm going to give you some of the questions that you have to solve in your notebook. See, whenever you are reading something, then you must solve, right? Okay, now question is, I am giving you wavelength. Here there are some questions. Wavelength, lambda is equal to 4 nm. What is the meaning of nm? Nanometer. Nanometer means 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Here lambda value I have given. You have to find nu means wavelength, wave number, and after then frequency. Got it? Can you calculate? See, wave number will be 1 upon lambda. And what will be the value of nu? Nu is equal to C by lambda. So you must remember the formula. Easily you can get the solution. Got it? So I hope all of you have understand. Now you can take a screenshot of your homework and you can solve this homework at your home. Now we are moving towards the next questions. Now the second type of question is of about the Planck's quantum theory. See, already as I have told you that here the intensity increases as the wavelength increases. So in the previous video also we have talked about it. So as the intensity increases, wavelength also increases. So intensity, you know very well, as it produces, it radiates energy. Means energy is directly proportional to lambda. Energy is directly proportional to lambda. So E is equal to means you can just say energy is proportional to frequency, as already I have told you about the intensity. Intensity and wavelength relation, as you have seen in your notebook also, you can see in your notebooks that wavelength and intensity, what is the relation of wavelength and intensity? The graph of the intensity with the wavelength at two temperature. So you can see both the temperature, the second temperature T2 is greater than T1. As it, this graph is represented in your textbook, NCERT textbook, you can see. And the electromagnetic radiation is proportional to the intensity and independent of its frequency or wavelength. Understand directly that intensity is directly proportional to frequency. Intensity is directly proportional to frequency. Now, here you can see that E is directly proportional to nu. So E is equal to nu H nu, where H is Planck's constant. What is the value of Planck's constant? 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. This is the value of, it's called Planck's constant. What is called? Planck's constant. As we have seen, E is directly proportional to nu. See, in the video already, in the previous video, I had explained you about this energy level concept. If you have not understand, then right now I am telling you that the quantum of energy, which is called photon, the energy of radiation is proportional to frequency, and it is expressed by an equation E is equal to h nu. E is equal to h nu. Can I write instead of nu hc by lambda? Because you know very well, as in the previous, right now only I have told you that c is equal to lambda into nu. So lambda is equal to c by nu, or nu is equal to c by lambda, right? So after getting this three information, instead of nu I have just written the c by. Now here H is Planck's constant. What is this? Planck's constant. Remember this. Now what you can calculate here? You can calculate frequency, you can calculate wavelength, you can calculate energy. Right? You can calculate all these three things. So now how you will calculate? As I am going to give you the numerical. Two radiations, one having the red color, wavelength 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter, and other with the orange color, wavelength 6.2 into 10 to the power minus 5. There are two radiations, red color and orange color. Both the wavelength are there, and which will have higher energy. So question is, two wavelengths are there, okay, lambda of red and lambda of orange. You have to calculate both their energies and which one is greater. Okay, so here the red wavelength is 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. Got it? And orange wavelength is 6.2 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. Now tell me, what should I do? Here lambda is given and I have to calculate E. So here you can see the formula. E is equal to hc by lambda. E is equal to hc by lambda. H means 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 into 3 into 10 to the power 8 upon 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 5. Right? Can we write like this? Yes or no? Yes, definitely. Else, question is what? If the wavelength is greater, so can you think that about the energy will be greater or lesser? Here at one step if you write, if you want to write, higher is the wavelength of the light, lesser will be its energy. Yes? See here. As the lambda will be greater, energy will be less. And as the lambda is smaller, energy will be more. So in the question they were asking you, whose energy is greater? This one or this one? So here you can see this value is greater. Which value is greater, can you tell me? 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 or 6.2 into 10 to the power minus 5? Can you tell me? See, 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 5 is greater, right? Definitely it is greater. And the orange color wavelength is 6.2 into 10 to the power minus 5. So if you want to compare both the radiation about the orange and red, then orange will have lesser wavelength. So compared to red, therefore orange will have higher frequency. Less wavelength, more frequency. So this is less wavelength, so orange will have more frequency. Right? As the more frequency, so the energy will be also greater. Now, if you want to find out the value, that whose energy is greater. So you have to do this for, this energy is for red wavelength, right? And now if I talk about orange one, then also you can take E is equal to hc by lambda, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34, joule second into 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Upon lambda is 6.2 into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeters. See, one thing you can do. What you can do? You can change this centimeter into meter. Or otherwise, if you want to change meter into centimeter, see, both the unit must be same. Got it? If the units are same, then only you can cancel them. Right? So if you want to just find the values of, see, here it is meter and here this is centimeter. So 1 meter is equal to how many centimeters? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. And 1 centimeter is equal to 1 by 100 meters. So 1 upon 10 to the power 5 centimeter is equal to 1 upon 100 into 10 to the power 5 meter. Means 1 upon 10 to the power 7 meter. Can we write? It is equal to 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So instead of meter, you can write, instead of centimeter, you can write meter here. So you can convert this centimeter into meter. So what will be the value? 10 to the power 5, instead of 10 to the power 5, it will become 10 to the power 7. As the 7 will go up. So here minus 27 and plus 8. So it will be minus 18. 6.626 into 3 upon 7.5 into 10 to the power. Minus 5, it will go up. So it will become minus 29. Minus 29 plus 8. So it will become 10 to the power 20. Got it? This is of red one. And orange one, 6.626 into 3 upon 6.2 into 10 to the power 20. So you can just suppose that if it is equal to 1, so here the value will be 3. but here it will be less, right? You know very well. Here, as just suppose I'm telling you, 6.2 is equal to 1 point something, if there is that, 1.1 or any other, or 1.0 into 3 into 10 to the power 21. So here it will be 3.0 into 10 to the power 21. And here, this much joule, energy SI unit is joule. As we multiply, so it will be 7 9 16 3. So either 9 or either 8, just suppose here 0.9 into 10 to the power 0.9 into 3, now so 2.7 will be 2.7 into 10 to the power 21 joule. Now you can compare both these, either red or orange, whose energy is greater? See, if you directly want to calculate, then once it is there, here, as already I have told you, as the lambda value will be lesser, so energy will be greater. Here the lambda value is less, so directly we can say the energy is greater. But if you want to verify this type of questions, so you can verify this. Got it? Now second question. Calculate the frequency and wavelength of a photon with energy 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15. Here, with the energy, means E value is given, and you have to calculate lambda and frequency. Can you calculate? It's very easy. Now see, energy value is given 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15 joule. 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15 joule. Okay, energy is given 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15 joule. You have to calculate photon's wavelength and frequency. Means you have to calculate what is the value of nu and what is the value of lambda. Can you calculate? E is equal to h nu. If you want to calculate the value of nu, is equal to E upon h. E value is given 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15 joule, and here h value is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Joule cancel. 3.98 upon 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 15 plus 34. So minus 19 will be there, 19 second inverse, right? So now you have to divide. Just suppose 39.8 into 10 to the power 18 upon 6.626. 6 6 are 36, right? 6.5 into 10 to the power 18. So hope you have understand about the frequency. Or if you want to just suppose, if here you are not getting any value, okay, then you can directly write 0. See, approximately also we can write it. If you don't want to write any other thing, then you can directly see. You have to either divide it, and if you have mathematical multiplication is strong, then you can divide easily. So this is the value of nu. Now you have to calculate lambda. Lambda is equal to Can you tell me what will be the value of lambda? instead of nu, here we can write hc by lambda e is equal to hc by lambda. Hc by lambda can be right, e is equal to hc. So therefore e is equal to h means 6. We have to calculate the value of lambda, right? So lambda energy value is given and we have to calculate lambda's value. So what will be the formula? Can you tell me? What will be the formula? Lambda is equal to hc by e. Lambda is equal to hc by e, right? So here lambda is equal to 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second upon 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 15 joule. Got it? So here, just suppose if you are cutting this 3.98 by 3, so what will be the value? Or you can do one thing. 3.982 ja. Right? Or directly you can calculate from here also. Sorry. Here you can see this is the value of nu, right? And we have just directly put here. Nu is equal to c by lambda, right? So here also if you want to calculate, so lambda will be c by nu. C value 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And nu value is 6 into 10 to the power 18 meter per second. Meter, no, sorry, second. Second cancel. 1 by 2 into 10 to the power, see 8 is there, so here 10 will be remaining, 10 to the power minus 10, right? And if you want to write here 0.5, see here you can calculate very easily, right? But if you want to follow the formula of that hc by lambda, that will be a little bit difficult. Here you can see we have calculated 10 to the power minus 10, and what is the 10 to the power minus 10 meter, you can tell you, right? Angstrom. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 to the power minus 10. If you want to do like that, that will be the easiest way to calculate lambda after getting the value of nu. Okay? So no need to write this. You can directly write this. Got it? Any doubt? So if this type of questions I provide you, so you can solve. Definitely you have to solve. I hope that you are understanding the concepts. Now I am going to give you the questions related to threshold frequency, that is work function. What is the work function W naught of the metal whose threshold frequency is equal to? First of all, you must know the concept about the work function. As already I described you about the threshold frequency, h nu is equal to h nu naught plus half mv square, and after that I had informed you about w naught, that is work function. W naught is equal to h nu naught. Work function is equal to h nu naught, right? So can you tell me what is the threshold frequency? Anyone? What is threshold frequency? Can you tell me? Everybody know, as I have told you, as the metal strikes in the Planck's quantum theory, after the photoelectric effect. In the photoelectric effect, I told you, when the light strikes with the metal, it must reach to the frequency. After reaching the frequency, then only the metal emits the electron, and that frequency is called threshold frequency. And frequency will be always greater than threshold frequency, right? Frequency will be always greater than threshold frequency. So here, h nu naught, right? H nu is equal to h nu naught plus half mv square. h nu is equal to h nu naught plus half mvs. This is kinetic energy, this is our threshold frequency, and this is our frequency. So now question is, what is this h nu? H nu is energy. Energy, and here, what amount of energy will be required? So this is the threshold frequency, and after that this is the kinetic energy as the electron. So this formula, according to this formula. And if anybody will ask you, what is work function? Work function is threshold frequency. How much work it have done to emit the electron. So here, as you get the value of this, that what is the value of work function, then you can directly say work function means threshold frequency. Now in this question, you have to calculate the work function. So as here work function, threshold frequency value is given. Nu naught is equal to 5.2 into 10 to the power 14 second inverse. Nu naught is equal to 5.2 into 10 to the power minus 14 second inverse. And you have to calculate work function. So work function is equal to h nu naught. What is the value of h? H is Planck's constant, 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into 5.2 into 10 to the power minus 14 second inverse. Second cancel. So here 6.626 into 5.2 into 10 to the power minus 34 and minus 14, minus 48, right? So as you multiply 6.626 and 5.2, you will get the value 3.44. Into 10 to the power minus 48 watt. Can you tell me what is the unit of work function? That is joule. Got it? So here, as the value of nu naught was given, means threshold frequency value was given. If I change the threshold frequency, just suppose if I change here minus 14 into the plus 14, then what will happen here? Plus 14, 14, and so here that will be minus 20. What will be here? Here it will become minus 20. Why minus 20? Because plus 14 in here. And after multiplying, as you will get 34.44, so as you increase, your answer will be in, what do you think? Where will be your answer? 10 to the power 14, as I give you the value in plus, and you know very well, your value will be 10 to the power approx. Just suppose here 34.4 will come. So here 10 to the power minus 19. Directly understand. 34.4. The answer will be here 34.4. So that's why if we increase here 10, so here the answer will be 10 to the power minus 19. Got it? So in this way, you can calculate the work function value. Okay, one more question I just want to give you. Same related question. So here, if I give you the threshold frequency, nu naught is equal to 6.62 into 10 to the power 10 second inverse. Can you calculate? Question number 2. This is question number 1. You have to calculate the frequency. What will be the value of frequency? You can see here. You must know about the MVS square, if you know that. Otherwise, just suppose that if I give you a question to calculate the work function only. So what is the value of work function, can you tell me? Is equal to h nu naught. Just what you have to do, the nu naught is equal to work function. H means 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into 6.62 into 10 to the power 10 seconds. Second cancel. As you multiply 6.6, 66 are 36. 39.6 into 10 to the power minus 34 and 10. So minus 24. Got it? So this type of question, as you get it, you can solve it very easily, right? Are you having doubt related to this work function or threshold frequency? If you are having any type of doubt related to this work function, threshold frequency or the kinetic energy, then please drop your doubt into the comment box section. Now we are moving towards the next question. A 100 watt bulb emits monochromatic light of wavelength 400 nanometer. Calculate the number of photons emitted per second. As already I have told you about the number of photons emitted. Which theory is this? Can you tell me? Photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect. What will be the formula of photoelectric effect? This one only, as already I have written here about the threshold frequency. You may have seen H nu is equal to H nu naught plus half mv square, right? So here question is, a 100 watt bulb, 1 watt is equal to joule per second, remember, 100 watt bulb is there. It is emitting a wavelength 400 nanometer. You have to calculate photons. Number of photons emitted is power of the bulb by energy of one photon. Power of the bulb by energy of one photon. Let me write the question first. Question is, power of the bulb how much it is? In the question it is 100 watt. So can you write in this joule second? 100 joules second. Okay? Now, what is power? Power is equal to energy upon time. Remember this formula. Power is equal to energy upon time. If you have pencil and pen with you, then please write this formula in your notebook. Now, energy of photon. What will be the value of energy of photon? E is equal to H nu. So, energy of photon is equal to H nu or HC by lambda. And in the question, wavelength is given, right? What is the value of wavelength? In the wavelength, it is 400 nanometer. Lambda is equal to 400 nm. Nm means 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Got it? So energy of one photon will be 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second into 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second upon 400 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Got it? What I have done, I have just put the values of it. 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second, not second. Yeah. And the light value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. And the wavelength value is given. So what will be the answer, you know? 4.969 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. 4.969 into 10 to the power minus 19. So this is the value of energy of a photon. Now how many photons has been emitted? So you can directly write number of photons is equal to power of the bulb by energy of one photon. What you will write? Number of photons is equal to power of the bulb. How much power of the bulb is there? Power of the bulb by energy of one photon. You have to write power of the bulb by energy of one photon. Energy of one photon. So here you can see power of the one bulb is 100 watt or 100 joule per second upon 4.969 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So what will be the value? Can you tell me? The value will be 2.012 into 10 to the power 20 second inverse or per second. This much number of photons will be emitted How much photons? 2.012 into 10 to the power 20 photons per second. You can write number of photons. So you can write here photons per second is equal to 2.012 into 10 to the power 20 photons per second. Photons per second. So as if you get this type of question, you can solve it easily. So can I give you one more question about the maximum kinetic energy? As already I have taught you about this threshold frequency relations. What is the relations of frequency and threshold frequency? So let me teach you one more numerical, and after then, this time you are going to get a special numerical assignment. Got it? So let me write a question. Question is, calculate the maximum kinetic energy of photoelectrons emitted when a light of frequency new value is 2 into 10 to the power 16 Hz is irradiated on a metal surface with a threshold frequency which is equal to 8.68 into 10 to the power 15 Hz. See what are given here. First of all, frequency is given, and second thing, threshold frequency is given. What is given? Frequency and threshold frequency. So first of all, we have to write, what is the formula? H nu is equal to H nu naught plus kinetic energy. What is the value of kinetic energy? Everyone knows, half mv square. What do you want to calculate in this question? You want to calculate the kinetic energy, means you have to calculate this half mv square formula, or directly you can write kinetic energy. So what will the kinetic energy? H nu minus H nu naught. So can we take H common? Nu minus mu naught. Here what are given in the question? Nu value is given and nu naught value is given. What is nu value? Nu value is 2 into 10 to the power 16 Hz. Means 2 into 10 to the power minus 16 per second. Per second is also known as Hz, right? And threshold frequency 8.68 into 10 to the power 15. 8.68 into 10 to the power 15 second. So now can you calculate what will be the value of kinetic energy? Easily you can calculate, right? So what we have to do? We have to just put into the formula, kinetic energy is equal to this half mv square is equal to this much only, h nu minus h nu naught. So what will be the value of h? 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. And new value is 2 into 10 to the power 16 per second minus 8.68 into 10 to the power 15. Now can you tell me what will be the value? So here you can see as 2 minus 8, right? 2 into 10 to the power 16 is there, and that side 15. So if I put here 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34, and here 20 minus 8.68 into 10 to the power 15. So here what I will get the value? 6.626 into 20 minus 8.68, it will be 11 point something, right? So 10 minus 8, 2, 9 minus 6, 3, 9 minus 8, 1. Right? Here just suppose 20.00. So what will be the value here? 11.32 into 10 to the power 15 into 10 to the power minus 34. Right? Okay. Now what about the SI unit? All of us know the energy SI unit is joule only, right? So what we have to do? 6.626 into 11.32. If you multiply 7.5, how much? 7.5, so this is 7.5 into 10 to the power minus 18 joule. So this will be our answer of kinetic energy. As you have seen, how to calculate the formula of kinetic energy. All of you are getting? So easily, whenever you get this type of questions, you can solve by yourself. See, remember, whenever you are getting numericals related problem, please focus on theoretical portion. As you get the answers of theoretical portion, definitely you will move high to high levels. As you understand theoretical portion, then you can solve this type of numericals. I'm going to give you the same questions, but you have to solve after watching the video. Nowadays, students are not watching the videos because of lockdown. See, I can understand whole world, not only our India, not only our mini state. I'm talking about the whole India and whole world is right now affected with this COVID-19 virus. So we must be aware about this virus, keep social distancing with each other. That's why we are providing you online classes. Wash your hands again and again. So if any other bacteria has stuck in your nails, so you can just take some sanitizer or you can take some hand wash, and you should wash your hands each hour, or you can say just after 2 hours you must wash your hands once. So you must be aware about this type of diseases. You must be having a knowledge that you should not go out. Yeah, I can understand you all are always going out. You must have a mood free. As you go outside, you take your vehicles, you go for 1 kilometer riding. But these are all we have to stop right now, because jaan hai to jahan hai, right? Agar zindagi hi nahi to kahan ghumoge. So that's why I'm telling you, stay at home, be safe, and request your family members also to be safe. That's all. Thank you very much. If you have liked this numerical questions, then put a like button and subscribe my channel. If you have not liked, then please put a comment on this video's below link. That's all for today. Thank you very much. Stay at home, stay safe.